you believe the word of the prophet, it will come to you. It will be between now and that time, because I know God is going to provide. Between now and that time, you know, one of your people living in the same room is saying, I meet you, this lady, I saw her on the street and I want to do something. Can you excuse me and vacate the room and so that I can do whatever I want to do? God forbid. I said God forbid. You will not leave the room for them. Because if you do, you are partakers of other people's sins. You are not being a partaker. Somebody came and he said, you know, I got this money from my office. And there is a large amount of money. And I want to keep it with you. To do, put it in your account. So that if they are searching, when they look at my account, they will not see anything. They say, me, I've graduated from that. I said, you have graduated from that. You're not a partaker of any exhibit. And they say they are stolen, they want to deposit it, let them look for another account. Your account will not be a 419 account. 419 man, anybody there? 419 lady, are you there? Not in our church. I said not in our church. You will not be partaker of anybody's sin in Jesus' name. And then it says, keep thyself how? Pure. Keep thyself pure. Keep thyself pure. You'll keep yourself pure. I said you'll keep yourself pure. My little boy, the creditor is coming. And he's going to knock at the door. And when he comes, tell him, I'm not at home. Is he at home? But tell him, I am not at home. What will you say? God forbid. How can me? I'm not going to tell your life for you. You stay at the door. When he knocks, tell you what? You tell him yourself that you are not at home. Then they will hear your voice. And they will know truly you are not at home. Praise the Lord. This year, you are not going to carry anybody's sin for him. Anybody's dirty load, you are not carrying for them. They are not partakers of other people's sins. Because this year is a year of holiness. Blameless purity in the name of Jesus. Why is that so? In 2 Timothy chapter 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19. 2 Timothy chapter 2. We're looking at verse 19. It says in verse 19, nevertheless, the foundation of God stand assured, having this seal, the Lord knows them that are his. And yet, everyone, how many people? Everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. I will be to honor. If a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work. Look at verse 22. Flee also, if lost. Don't wait there and allow those, terrible, defiled tempters and temptresses to get you on, and then defile your life. Run away from them. Flee also, if lost. And then it says, but follow righteousness and faith and charity and peace. What them that call on the Lord, out of what kind of heart? Out of a pure heart. Out of a pure heart. Why are we going to keep on calling upon the Lord out of a pure heart? Because that's what it is for us to get into heaven. We're looking at Psalm 24. Psalm 24. I'm reading to you there from verses 3 and 4. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He that has clean hands and a pure heart. He that has clean hands and what? And a pure heart. That's what it takes to get to heaven. That's what it takes for God to remain with us and favorable unto us. Have you noticed about those people in the Bible that had that purity of heart, purity of life, and they were pure through and through, and there was no defilement in their lives anytime? Let me give you a list of them. Number one is Enoch. Enoch. And what do you say about Enoch? He walked with God. Can two walk together except they be agreed? As we think about Enoch, you are thinking about purity and partnership. Purity and partnership. The Lord will not be partner to anyone that is defiled, anyone that is impure, anyone that is unrighteous, anyone that is unholy. But purity and partnership, Enoch demonstrates that. Look at another man. Number two is Joseph. Joseph, he is the one that had that big dream. And he said, I saw in the dream the sun and the moon and the stars, and they were bowing down to me. And then went to the field, and the sheaves, my sheep was standing like this, and then all the sheaves, everything bowed down. It was a promise, a prophecy of promotion. And because that man remained pure, you have purity and promotion. This year, we're going to be promoted. On the basis of the purity, the partnership with God on the basis of purity, and the promotion from God on the basis of purity. Another person is Samuel. You see, Samuel, he was in that house of Eli. Ophni was there, and Phinehas, he was there too. And those young people, they were doing some evil things, defiling, corrupting things. But Samuel said, I'll not be like them. You'll be different. This year you are going to be different. And then that young man, he didn't even know, because the voice of God, the prophecy was no more coming to Eli, no more coming to Ophni and Phinehas, but the Lord began to reveal to that young man great prophecies, and the Lord made him a prophet right there, because he gets into purity. That's purity and prophecy. Purity and prophecy. And then we have another man, that's Elijah. That's Elijah. That man was pure. This is a holy man of God. And he will not partake of Ahab's sin. He will not partake of the defilement of the land. And you know about Elijah, that's the prophet of fire, the prophet of power. Purity and power, they all go together. If anybody wants to have power with God, you must have that purity. Purity and partnership, purity and promotion, purity and prophecy, purity and power. Think about Daniel, think about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Those were the people that said, no, we're not going to bow to any idol. And we're told about Daniel, he purposed in his heart, he will not defile himself, or the king's meat, or the portion of the wine that he drank. That was pure. What do you find about Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Purity and protection. The Lord protected them, the Lord will protect you. You know, anywhere we go, he'll say, let no one touch mine anointed. Because purity brings protection in our lives. Do you remember in the New Testament, his name is Paul the Apostle. That Paul, he said, I labored more abundantly than you all. What gave him the power to be able to be productive above all the other people is purity. Purity and productivity. Purity and productivity. And now Stephen. Remember Stephen, the first martyr. And when he was turning in, he looked up and he said, I see also the Lord standing, ready to receive him. And he said, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Purity and paradise. Purity and paradise. And if you are going to make it on the final day, and I know you want to make it. I said, I know you want to make it. You are going to have that purity in your heart and in your life. That is what it takes. Purity and partnership, purity and promotion, purity and prophecy, purity and power, purity and protection, purity and productivity, purity and paradise. We'll have it in Jesus' name. We're looking at 2 Peter chapter 3. 2 Peter chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 9. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but he's not suffering towards what? Not willing that any should perish. You will not perish. I said you will not perish. for that all should come to repentance. If you will yield to the Lord, surrender to the Lord and become penitent and repentant, you will not perish in Jesus' name. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and all the, and the walls that are therein shall be burnt up. See then that all these things shall be dissolved. What manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness, because of the judgment that is to come, and because of the wrath of God going to report upon this world. That's why the Lord is saying, you must live your life in purity, all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and a new earth, wherein dwelleth righteousness. Wherefore, beloved, see that ye look for such things, be diligent that ye may be found of him in peace, without spot and blameless. Blameless purity and renewed consecration. Welcome to point number 7. Boundless power. Everybody say boundless power. This year is a year of power in our church. I said it's a year of power in our church. In the children church, boundless power. In the youth section, boundless power. On our campuses, campus fellowship, boundless power. Among our corporates, boundless power. Among our sisters, our mothers, our women, boundless power. Among our men, members, boundless power. Our coordinators, group coordinators, overseers, when they preach, Thursday, crusade, whatever, revival this year, boundless power. And with our pastor, our general superintendent, what do we have? Boundless power. When you see me for counseling, there will be boundless power. When I touch your life, and if I want to shake you, I will do anything I want to do, I will just shake your hand. And when I shake your hand, what will happen? Explosive power, boundless power in Jesus' name. This year is a year of power. In our church, at Sunday scripture time is going to be time of power. Praying time is time of power. Bible study time is time of power. And the power will be upon your life in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Looking at Genesis chapter 32, verse 24. Genesis chapter 32. I'm looking at here from verse 24. And Jacob was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the pollen of his thigh. You're going to find that the hand of the Lord will touch this year. While you're sleeping, it will touch you. While you are awake, it will touch you. And when that hand touches you, power will touch you. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go. Except thou bless me. And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, I am Jacob. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. This year, the Lord has changed your name. You are now a child of God. You are now a star in the kingdom. And this new name will get on your life and will be effective in your life in Jesus' name. And then he says, for us in place, thou hast power with God and power with men, and us prevail. This year you will prevail. The power to prevail the Lord will give to you in Jesus' name. Everything that prevailed against your life in the past years, this year you are going to prevail over them. Hosea chapter 12. Hosea chapter 12. I'm going to read from verse 3. Hosea chapter 12. We're looking at verse 3. He took his brother by the heel in the womb, And by his strength, he had power with God. This year, you'll have power with God. And verse 4, yea, he had power over the angel and prevailed. He went and made supplication unto him. He found him in Bethel. You will find God. And there he spake with us. Even the God of hosts, the Lord, is his memorial. Therefore turn thou to thy God. Because of the boundless power he wants to put in your life, turn unto your God. Keep mercy and judgment and wait on thy God continually. And then that power will be seen in your life. Luke chapter 10, boundless power for you, for me, for us, for our church all together. Luke chapter 10, we're looking at verse 19. Behold, I give unto you power. I know you heard that before, but it's a new day. I said it's a new year. And this is a new period in your life. If you never felt the power of God in your life before, you'll feel the power from today. Behold, I give unto you power to tread of serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy. Did I see it well? I said, did I see it well? Over what? Over all the power of the enemy. No remnant of power. I said, no remnant of power. Any charcoal, they grind together and they say, put it for him. Let him sit on it. So that when he sits on it, bad luck will come. I say, that is nonsense. They will not catch you. I said, they will not catch you. He said, it's coming, it's coming. Put something on the ground. When he matches on it, all that thing, the pastor is telling them, they will ascend, they will go up, they're going higher ground, for where? We're going to see. Go and march on everything, we neutralize it. Because the Lord will go before you. His strength will go before you. All the serpents, all the scorpions, all the beasts, you overcome them in Jesus' name. I give unto you power over all the power of the enemy. And then it says nothing. Everybody say nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Not a Pharisee, not a Sadducee, not a Herod, and not a Nebuchadnezzar will be able to lay hands upon you this year in Jesus' name. In the day, nothing shall hurt you. In the night, nothing shall hurt you. In your place of work, nothing shall hurt you. At school, nothing will hurt our children. And when you are doing your exam, nothing will hold your brain. That will be flowing out and flowing out. And when you feel you give that paper to them, you say, give me first class back. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Nothing shall by any means touch in Jesus' name. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rejoice because